fabric of Bern. These are 10 stonemasons, conservators, sculptors. Since 2 years we have employed restorators as well. One is from the SUPSI even. So I just step back a little bit and tell you how the Bauhütte, the fabric, worked in the past and then how we work today. Is that not working? Francesca? Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Okay, here's the point.
And I have to.
Oh, you might need to do this.
Okay. So, La Fabrica di Berna, the fabric of Bern, was established in 1881 for the completion of the spire. So, if you see the cathedral here, until the 19th century it looked like this, and they built the spire at the end of the 19th century. For that, the fabrica was relaunched. It didn't exist in the 17th and in the 18th century. So, this was first, it was a society that was running the fabric, and it was changed to a foundation in 1993. And we are now we have a contract with the Berner Münster Stiftung Foundation, which is managing the whole works at the cathedral and managing the workshop as well, the fabrica. So the fabrica did what they could best do after the completion of the spire. In 1893, they continued in rebuilding the cathedral. They were good stonemasons, they were good sculptors, and they replaced one stone after another. And if you see the result now, it doesn't work. It doesn't? No. Oh. Aha. This is Bernice. PowerPoint. Goes very slow. As you can see the effect of the constant renewal of the cathedral. This is the southern facade. Everything that is red has been replaced once or several times in time, since the 16th century until the 19th. And a whole lot of stones, the green ones, have been replaced in the 20th century. This was because the fabrica was completing the spire, then they worked further and replaced one stone after another then. So we thought in 1998 that we couldn't continue like this, because otherwise we have a cathedral from the 20th century in a few years and no more a medieval building. So we changed the paradigm, we changed the strategy. I just show you the effects on the facade. You look at this portal on the north side, how it changed its style during the renovation. You look at this, the long-lasting renewal campaign from the 19th century and until the end of the 20th century had its effects also in the habitus of the building and how it looks like. You can see the portal around 1870 and then the same portal around 1900. It is built in better Gothic style. They removed the shelter. The idea was to rebuild the Gothic style like it was in the medieval. But, you know, it looks a bit death now, if you look at that. And they were throwing away all the architecture of the portal. The angels were integrated in the choir of the cathedral, but the rest has been gone, has been sold maybe even. The renewal and redesign of cornice, balustrades and architectural elements from 19th had its effects as well. You can see, for example, this element, which has been renewed in the 18th century, and in the 20th century people thought that it was not Gothic enough and they rebuilt it in the Gothic style, but we never knew what the Gothic style is, as it's more medieval than it ever was before, actually. From 1906, the fabrica had not enough work to complete. And they wrote to the architects that they should have new work until Saturday. Then again, in June 1906, they wrote again to the architect that now they should really have work because they're running out of it and people are waiting for work. So they started with the renewal of the whole Strebeweg, the whole northern nave. You see the effect, it looked like this before. This is how it looks like today. So the biggest danger for a building like that can also be a fabrica that is working on the stone all the time. This is a bit dangerous if I say that like this, but it had this effect on Bern Cathedral. You can see the main portal, for example. This was another tragedy. This was musealization of things. The sculptures of the main portal have all been copied in the fabrica from 1964 to 1991. They have been placed in a museum. You can see that here. They are placed in a museum out of context. You cannot make the link to the cathedral anymore, and replaced by really nice copies on site. But it was linked to a big damage on the building as well, because they didn't just renew the sculptures, which you can take like this and put in a museum, but they also renewed the whole architecture. You can see that here. Or here, for example, these consoles have been changed as well. They looked like this. They are now in the fabrica. They were lying in the floor in front of the fabrica when we took it over in 1998. Now they're secure in the building, but still today we wouldn't change this anymore. The myth of the copy that is true to the original, you can be doubted as well. You see here the original sculpture from the 16th century and its copy on the right side, which is quite different from the original. If you see the little details here, this is the handwriting of the sculpture, which is not bad, I think, but if you are trying to talk about the Middle Ages, on this basis, this is a bit dangerous. And you see also the polychromy has been renewed, and 20 years later it has its problems, although the polychromy of the original is was in really good state after 500 years. So it's not said that a new copy and a new polychromy is doing the best, is functionally better. 8 of 14 Clare stories were replaced in 1988 to 1998. This was the last big stone replacement, so one window after another has been replaced because of static devices. They thought it was a danger of collapse. And we talked to the engineer afterwards. They said he didn't know what they are doing and he never checked it, actually. So they didn't just renew the inner, the masswerk, I don't know how to say it in English, they renewed also the facade, in fact. When we took over the fabrica in 1998, it looked like this behind the tower, behind the big scaffold that was hanging for 20 years on the same place. It looked like in a great building site. And everything was demolished, if you see that. The whole outer skin of the building has been taken down and was been rebuilding. We finished this work, but this was the last great renovation phase of Bern Cathedral then. From now on, we were working differently. Until 1998, this is the same person as this person. This person in 1998 told me that me with a spatula like that, like restoring something, never, because I'm a stonemason, I have to replace stones on like cubics of stones. Now he's our best stone restorer. We trained our people on the site. We were talking to a lot of restorers, a lot of people who helped us, educating our people to stone conservators. Since 2014, they are even restoring and conservating vaults, paintings. So, for example, in the vaults of the choir from 14 to 17, just completed. It's not that we replaced the handcraft, but we did. Went more diverse, in fact. Instead of have one remedy, they have now 15 or 16 remedies to treat the damage of the stone. because we are always told that we are a danger for the handcrafts, we are a danger for the stonemasons. It's not like this. We trained them to actually enlarge their handcraft, their crafts, and their skills. Basic values. For us, the respect for the heritage is what matters, in fact. So you can see from 2002, we didn't replace practically any stones. A little few bits here, a little bits in the spire. We were restoring the whole spire, and there was 1% of new stones. Maximum 1%. The rest has been conservated and restored with techniques you know all very well as restorers, with mortar, with filling the joints, with preventive care and palliative care. You can see the whole amount of areas that have been conservated since 2002. If you go back to the image on the big scaffold on the tower that was hanging for 20 years on one place, we are quite more efficient now. This has been done last year and this year. So afterwards, we have to care and set up a maintenance system. That's actually now the theme of the whole thing. How do we do that? We think that first, the observation, you have thought about that already, Francesco. Maybe it is really dangerous, like in the choir, we had to remove all the pinnacles because there are tourists around there and they are really in a bad condition. So we took them down into the fabric, we restored it into the fabric, and then we replaced them. They are not renewed, but restored, in fact. Or we install a little net, safety net, so we can save that painting. We don't have to remove it immediately because it could fall down. So this net will prevent us from a case of guarantee or a tourist that is going to be this. Time to think. This is an angel where someone was looking for the original painting in the choir. He was convinced that there is no more original painting. So the preconception was that it was repainted several times in the past. And he was looking for the original, not remarking that he is always through the original on the stone. So mind, if you go there, don't go there with a preconception. Think about it. Interventions, cleaning, consolidation, closing cracks and joints, repairing defects, retouching, and protection from water. That is what we do. The documentation is very important. We do a mapping. We have new technologies like 3D models, for example, in the choir, which prevents us from doing plaster casts, which damage the surface when it is painted. We try to be true to our measures and also document mistakes that we have made. For example, when we consolidated the stone in the beginning, we did it until the excess. We did it really, we filled it, the stone, with consolidation. And we wouldn't do that anymore. Well, less is more, we know now. You know that, everybody knows that. But we mapped it like that, and we control it every year. We didn't see any damages now. Or we have some testing areas on site, where we tested oiling of the surface, or a casein painting. Like protection from graffiti. So these are zones that we check periodically and more often. The central archive we established is very important, so we have the possibility to find the relevant documents and to work on it afterwards. It was like this in the fabric, in really bad conditions, the plans and all the documents. We took it together in one Minster archive. We have now databases to find our documents, and most of all we have a simple orientation system where everybody is talking from the same people are now talking from pillar 30 on the south side or pillar 50 on the north side, and everybody knows where they have to go. Before it was the pillar upon the chapel of Jesus Christ, and the other said it was the pillar just nearby the chapel of von Erlach, and you never knew what they were talking about. The monitoring plan is a long-term observation in situ. We don't have big lists, we don't have big files, we don't have big databases, but we do it inside. Reasonable measuring equipment, we talk about that just shortly. Test tubes on site and in laboratory. Untreated surfaces, we always leave a reference surface which is not treated, so we can refer to it. If we have any damage, we can compare it to the area which was not treated. So the exchange of knowledge is very important, multidisciplinarity as well, permanent reflection, permanent learning. So what does that mean on site? This is a pillar which was conservated in 2001. These bits have not fallen off like that. They were knocked down because there were cars parking around the pillar. So the cars were more important than the substance of the monument. First we did was removing those parking spaces, put them somewhere else, and then we could restore this. It was restored, conservated with mortar. You can see the how it was done. So this is the state 2001, before we did something, 2002, 2013. You can see these methods are very well adopted to the element. And 2019, it begins a little bit with a scale in the upper part of the pillar, which was a cement mortar, not a mortar from us, but a mortar who has been installed in 1910, with a really hard mortar with a lot of cement, so this didn't work. We have structural supervision, of course, because we also have to testify to the judges if something falls down, like in Santa Croce. We have a lot of points that were measured in the cathedral, around 250 points, which are measured regularly, which measure every movement of the building. And if something falls down, like here, a little bit of mortar, you can always check if the building was moving or not. So you don't have to break out in panic. You can say, no, it's not moving the building. It was just because they were heating a bit too much, maybe, and it was draining the mortar and it fell down afterwards. So no need of big measures. Long-term references inside, we have our mortars testing on all four facades on the tower. They work very well. We have also products which you can buy on the market, which are exposed on the tower, four sides, just to compare. And if we have a problem somewhere, that we know which mortar we could use, maybe, instead of our mortar, own mortar. Cycles of maintenance from 2014, you see, this is the only plan for the monitoring, in fact, that we have. It is adopted every year. That is a great need. That has been done now from 2005 to 2010. Then we have a medium need, 3 to 5 years to check it. Less need, this is the building parts in good condition, which we take in 5 to 10 year cycles. Then we have the catch-up needs. These are the red parts, where a long time nothing has been done, and it needs restoration now. And there are areas of special interest, where we have special problems like cracking or something like that. We do the monitoring with a skyscraper hanging in the rope. It is really important that you guarantee the accessibility in a building like the cathedral. So we are now installing monitoring devices, monitoring elements, so that we can check the facade, not only in the rope, but hanging in a little seat like that, which is more comfortable. And there are skyscrapers that go further up now. time is working for us. And we have a big element here in the tower where we can put up things. So that is in work now, because if you don't have the access, it is difficult to guarantee the maintenance afterwards. Control summary from 2009 looks like this. Some parts who have to be checked in 2019, it looks like this then. So the building is constantly living and constantly moving, so and we have those little plans. These measures are then completed in the next year until the next control. We have patient sheets from every area of the building. Looks like this. Now I go a bit quick. We have testing areas on site. This is a balustrade which dates from 1963. It was completely renewed end of the 20th century. And in 1963, and in really bad condition again in 1998, it was already meant to be replaced again. So we tested some painting on it, because it was already given up and condemned to death, the element. We checked a lot of methods, like in an anatomy, in the medicine. You can test whatever you want, doesn't matter because it's already dead, the element. So now it is still there. We restored it with mortar, we filled the joints, and we painted it with oil paint. We wouldn't do that in another area of the cathedral. Here we did it, and it did well. It worked well. Maintenance. We do the maintenance every 5 years. We repaint it, we maintain it. Main concerns are the early detection of deterioration, improvement and developments, and most of all, avoidance of big errors. We don't have methods that we apply around the whole cathedral if we are not sure that it works. So doing less more often, this is Julian James who said that, and we work after that. Efficiency, you can see the renovation of the tower when they were renewing the stones. It took over 50 years to renovate the lower part of the tower. With our methods, we were conservating the whole octagon in 5 years and the whole spire in 4 years. And now we are doing the maintenance already. We have several inspections running. You can see the intervals. And our measures are also in good condition so far. The cost, it costs less if we work like that. If you see that pinnacle on the north side, renewed in sandstone, it costs around 1.5 million Swiss francs. And was occupying the whole fabric for 2 years. The other one on the south side, we conservated with the new methods we adopt in the fabric, and it cost much less, you can see that, and was conserved in only half a year. Condition was like that. Finally stated the joint was filled afterwards, is like that, without any stone replacement. Authenticity. You can see one of the clerestories that have been replaced in the 1980s, 1990s, the original and the copy. If you look at these parts, you can see that even the picture of the facade has been changed. Here you see some holes from old scaffolds from the medieval area. They have gone now. So we try to keep all these traces of the history on the facade. Today we wouldn't do that anymore like this. If we now take a window out of the scaffold, it looks like this, still old, still a medieval element, but it's doing better now. Again, before and after. Before, condition before, like really bad damages. Sandstone has already gone in some parts, and the final condition after conservation. You can still see elements that have been moving in time. We left them like that. You can see that here as well, before and after. You can still read all the traces of history, like what happened here, for example. You can see that. Acquisition of knowledge, we do practical research. We don't go to the laboratory at first. We test it in the fabrica, in the workshop. We test it on site, and if it works, if people can work with it, then we put it to the laboratory to test it. Main challenges is the education and the transfer of knowledge. Communication, because if we take the scaffolds down today, people don't see anything that has been done. So you have to justify that you have been working, that you have been using the money for the right thing. The administration budget policy is sometimes a really counterproductive, because if they have the annual budget and no budget for the services, the annual service, we always have to fight for it with public authorities. I think you know that theme. So you have to fight for the service contracts, in fact. We are comfortable because we have the fabrica. You don't. If you go to the building sites, you have to fight for it afterwards. Regulations and standards, we don't always work after the norms. Communication, just the last picture. We try to show to the politicians and to the visitors what we are doing with the money. So this is a reference area before cleaning and after cleaning, just to show them that the effect will be nice in their eyes. And afterwards we leave a little bit reference area which has not been treated, so you can show them from the bottom, from the ground, that something has been done. This is really, really important, because people have to be behind these measures and give the money. Voilà. Communication, far capire. We try to have an open communication. We have a website. You can read everything what we do with all the basic recipes as well. We can do some visualizations. We don't have to repaint these elements on site. We can show it on 3D models, for example. So this is a really big part, communication. Thank you. Now that we look at the facades, like really close to
thank you. Thank you so much for your presentation. I was wondering how much time it took to convert the masons to the maintenance strategies. I think that was really shocking for them at the beginning.
Ah, okay. Better now. It was a little revolution, you're right. And we did that in parallel of the big replacements. We trained them parallel to the big construction sites. So it took about 5 years, maybe, and it was not everybody that was coping with it. So some people said they would not work like that, and they left the fabric.
And did you add conservators next to them and make them work
yes.
in tandem?
Yes, we had help from Andreas Walser, for example. I don't know if you know him. It was a conservator from the eastern part of Switzerland who was working like that for 30 years already. And he was coming to the fabrica, and he gave us all his recipes and all his knowledge, in fact. So that was a great chance.
Thank you.
Annette, who is taking the decision at the end if you have to conserve, preserve a piece of stone or if you have to replace it?
So it is the head of the fabrica and we as architects who are looking at the parts, and then we decide whether we replace it or not. Mostly it is not replacing. If we want to replace it, we have the Münsterbau Collegium. This is a committee of the, how do you say, Denkmalpfleger? The responsible for the patron,
cultural heritage.
Which are five persons who are controlling us, in fact.